So the next couple of speakers, I'm really excited to dive into that topic. So I know we are running a little bit behind, so just a little bit of a forewarning with our upcoming speakers. If we could keep it to our time frame, that'd be great. But I really want to welcome up Amy Padolf with Growing Beyond Earth to the stage, and I'll let Amy take it from here.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for having me. My name is Amy Padolf. I am the very proud director of education at Fairchild Tropical Botanic Garden in sunny Miami, Florida. So for those of you who are dealing with North Dakota weather, I apologize for the picture behind me. But I'm here to share with you the Growing Beyond Earth project, which was created and facilitated by Fairchild Tropical Botanic Garden in partnership with NASA. I'm excited to share with you how the program came about, its impact, and where it's going with the help and support of NASA's Science Mission Directorate and key science mission experts at Kennedy Space Center, including Ralph, who you just heard from. So let me just share with you. Whoops. We're having flip issues. All right, there we go.
There we go.
Of course, I have to be the one, right? Growing Beyond Earth has two components. There is the Growing Beyond Earth Challenge and the Growing Beyond Earth Innovation Studio. All right. So the Growing Beyond Earth Challenge is the first one I'm going to talk to you about a little bit. It is a multi-classroom science, a citizen science-based project designed to advance NASA's research for growing plants in space. Growing Beyond Earth is addressing NASA's identified challenges by expanding the diversity and quality of edible plants that's being grown aboard spacecraft. And yes, I said in the classroom. On Earth, Growing Beyond Earth is advancing technologies for growing plants in urban, indoor, and other limited resource environments. So Growing Beyond Earth is unique in its focus is on real scientific research, enabling students, citizen science to scientists to contribute data towards NASA's mission planning. Each classroom receives a Fairchild designed plant habitat that's analogous to the Growing Beyond Earth equipment aboard the International Space Station. Currently, we have over 600 middle and high schools across the nation and in countless places across the world. More than 50,000 students to date have been participating in the Growing Beyond Earth project. You can see the equipment. So the bottom picture you might recognize, and that is astronaut Shannon Walker. She's working with the Veggie system aboard the International Space Station. And the system at the top with the student is the Growing Beyond Earth Veggie growth chamber that we developed to mimic what's on the International Space Station. We worked alongside the NASA scientists and researchers to make sure it was the same size, same shape, same lighting, and similar growing techniques as on the Veggie system. Fairchild and NASA scientists Dr. Joya Massa, Trent Smith, Ralph Fritchie, Ray Wheeler, and Jacob Torres are training teachers to conduct this in-classroom experiment. And students are sharing their experimental data online with NASA researchers. The program is yielding some incredible results, both scientific and educational. Each year we provide the equipment free of charge with all of the materials to conduct a prescribed research study. Oops, I apologize. Students follow rigorous research protocols and have the opportunity to grow plants in their classroom, collect important data, analyze the results, and propose original research that they conduct in a second trial. So there's a first trial at the beginning of the year that is prescribed by the NASA researchers based on information we know about certain plants that meet certain criteria NASA is looking for. At the end of the academic year, students do a second research trial where they propose original research based on the data that they collected and different ideas collected from other schools. They present their original research to NASA scientists, administrators, researchers at their student research symposium that happens each year in April, which is coming up. Some students take it even a step further and submit their work for professional conferences. We had a group of students for the last 4 years who presented at the ASGSR conference, which is the Association of Gravitational and Space Research. So it's pretty cool. Teacher surveys indicate that Growing Beyond Earth is improving STEM instruction in middle and high schools. The program is uniquely effective in serving groups of underrepresented students. Through the program, students have become more knowledgeable about STEM topics, more confident when participating in STEM activities, and interested in STEM careers. And then there are the scientific results from this project. So they're actually yielding important scientific data. You can see this is a data that was collected over the last, this was a few years ago. I was collected, and you can see that we've tested a whole bunch of different varieties of plants. We've tested 180 different varieties of plants in the classrooms over the years. 10 varieties of top performers were studied further at Kennedy Space Center, and 5 varieties were studied on the International Space Station. And what's really interesting is that you can see that some of these plants, the data is really well grouped together. It's got that nice normal bell curve, and some of them didn't do so well, and they weren't quite as rigorous as the other ones. We've also had students doing some testing of the materials. We've created a tabletop growth chamber that mimics the International Space Station, a light panel that's adjustable LEDs and fans so you can do light recipe tests, moisture wicking systems, classroom protocols and training materials, and a programmable environmental controls. The results, 15 student publications, presentations, and professional conferences. Pretty incredible stuff. The second component of the Growing Beyond Earth project is the Innovation Studio. It's called the Growing Beyond Earth Innovation Studio, also supported by funding from NASA. It's a makerspace designed to address the technology of indoor agriculture, funded completely by the help of NASA. Funding. Originally, it was designed to use some of the same systems that we have for our variety trials to help NASA find solutions to some of the technical issues. This originated after meeting Ralph Ritchie for one of the first or second times. Ralph has this huge whiteboard, and on the whiteboard, there are plans for the deep space gateway and moon and Mars, but he recognized that there were some technological issues, and I'm sure that you're all aware of those types of things. And so we designed this in order to use the same sort of system that we were using to figure out what edible plant varieties were best to do the same thing with technical aspects of growing plants in space. It is the world's first makerspace in a botanic garden. It's dedicated to improve technology of food production. It includes digital design and fabrication equipment, and it hosts a nationwide challenge for high school, collegiate, and professional teams to address some of these issues. Over the last 4 years, we have hosted 3 maker challenges, hackathons, workshops, and for professional, collegiate, and high school students to address those issues. Growing Beyond Earth Maker Challenge produced more than 300 new plant habitats designed with innovative use of three-dimensional space, automatic environmental controls, and robotic planting and harvesting systems. Within the space, we now focus on having our community design and test programmable sensors systems, image capture systems, and conducting material tests in partnership with NASA, all together to help figure out some of the solutions to some of these larger problems. Altogether, both of these components of the Growing Beyond Earth has allowed us to partner with so many organizations, specifically NASA and all the great scientists, including Ralph and Dr. Joya Massa, to allow students and the community to help contribute their time and their ideas to finding solutions when there currently aren't any. So with that, I want to say thank you for allowing me to come and talk a little bit about our program.